TMM. So what we will do, and but what happens generally when we define only one level of refinement, its direct mesh transforming from main area to this refinement area is very much not in a seamless. It's like look like a step, large steps. But now with the improved mesh quality, you can define layers with the number of refinements you need. So you can see that now I have defined only one layer, not two layers. So you can see that the subdivision within the layers of mesh is very much improved. Again, three layers and four layers and so on. So this is the number of refinements for only one layer. We can define it for multiple layers of shells in flow simulation, which gives much detail of simulation with in meshing of external analysis, which gives more accurate result throughout the validation, and also it gives a very much improved results in area. Now we will see how does it work. So this is our airfoil geometry, which is we are trying to validate in a external environment. So also you can see that we have a new mesh editing and manipulating option within the feature manager, which is very easy to now use. Now from here we can use number of layers, how many layers and how many shells we want to define. So I have defined it only three layers with three refinements and done. Now using the cut plot, we can see that we have got much detailed results around the higher pressure zone and low pressure zone. Here is the low pressure zone, which gives us required level of details in validation. Also, we can create some dummy body, which gives good detail of vorticity creating around the geometry. So we can easily create see the where the vorticity is happening, chances of vorticity is creating or happening. Again, in SOLIDWORKS 2016, now when we define some new projects or new wizard using a new wizard command, we define some new projects. Now, if we are trying to do some radiation or some sunlight radiation project, we can directly import the SOLIDWORKS from SOLIDWORKS library the sunlight properties. For your location, you can just define your location and it will give all the details using environmental details, SOLIDWORKS. In built-in library, so it's very easy, because earlier you have to do collect all the knowledge of what's the your latitude, what's your longitude, what are the environmental condition in your place, and but it was time consuming and also a headache. But now in built-in library you can use all that. Again, SOLIDWORKS 2016 have improved the transient thermal analysis for transient flow simulation. Earlier, when we used to do some transient analysis, we don't have an option to control the number of iteration for transient analysis. But now we have an option to control the number of transient analysis, how many iteration it will take, how much short time step it will take, and this really very much affect the time of solving, because earlier we don't want to take a small time steps because it used to take long times. But now from using that solving option, here we have the option to define number of iteration and number of time steps we can define. So using larger time step and larger iterations, we can solve very easily and very fast. So comparing I have done two different analyses using basic and standard setting, and now this nested setting, you can see that when I compare these two options, earlier with the standard setting it was taking approx 1500 seconds, but with the nested setting it takes only 200 seconds, which is a very much substantial time not only time saving, but it gives much better detailing, because you have defined number of steps by yourself and you can get desired detail. Also you can use multiple cut plots, animate you can simultaneously. so you can get better visualization of how it's working. This is a room which is there is a ventilation option for methane gas, so you can see that how methane gas is ventilating from this room. So with the new functionality introduced in SOLIDWORKS 2016, flow simulation have been very much improved, and we can say that SOLIDWORKS have not give us to a options to do validate things or something create and design. It gives us a platform to innovate things. You can visualize in much detail option and in very short time. So it gives you a confidence and it gives you chance and time to do more R&D on your design and your validation. So in short, we can say that using new functionality and new improvements, we can solve the complex problem very easy in very much details. Thank you.
Thanks, Nadir, for giving a very good insight on what's new in validation.